Our final guest today is one that I've had such a great time with, and it's so wonderful to have her here and to hear Lee's words about Elvis's feelings about our next guest, and I think ours are the same, Linda Thompson. I hope you got to hear some of what Lee had to say about
it. You know, I didn't, but he came back and told me that he was talking about when he was in the dressing room and Elvis was talking to me on the phone.
Yeah.
And
like the only place Elvis could go for privacy was to go in and the door was closed and the phone line was under the door.
But how great is Lee Majors, you guys? Isn't it? A little known fact, he actually paid for my wedding with Bruce Jenner. He does want his money back. But he paid for the wedding. I don't think I'm kidding either. No, I'm kidding.
Find it as the spotlight hit this necklace. It's just, you know.
I wore this for y'all. I usually keep this in the safe deposit box as I do all the Elvis jewelry. You know, it's such a treasure for me, and the world is so crazy today. You know, I don't wear jewelry. Well, I lie. These are the things I bought myself, though. But Elvis jewelry I keep in a safe deposit box. But I thought the fans would like to see my TLC that Elvis dubbed the mother of all TLCs. So the ones that he would put around the ladies' necks were beautiful and gold, but smaller. And he designed this and had this made specifically for me. It's got baguette diamonds in the lightning bolt and round diamonds in the TLC, tender loving care. And he said, you know, you deserve this. You treat me so well with such tender loving care. So you get the mother of all TLCs, which is very sweet.
Tell us, the official Linda Thompson TLC.
I'd like to take credit for it, but it's really the Elvis Presley way of creating a peanut butter and banana sandwich. You mash the bananas, it has to be a ripe banana, you mash it up, blend peanut butter in the mashed bananas, take two pieces of white bread, preferably, you know, Wonder Bread, and put the mixture in the bread, and then you melt a stick of butter.
A stick.
Pretty much a stick. It's a lot of butter. And you saturate both sides of the bread and fry it like a toasted cheese, like a grilled cheese sandwich, but it's peanut butter and banana. And you know, honestly, I don't think I ever saw him eat a full one, but he just wanted to have a few bites. I told you this story last night about he would ask me too, honey, would you go downstairs and make me some bacon and eggs? And I said, well, do you want Pauline or Lottie or somebody to do it? No, I want you to do it because it tastes better when you make it. And I said, okay, so of course I accommodated him. Went down, and the first time I ever made bacon and eggs for him, it was like three eggs, you know, and four slices of bacon. I go back up with the tray and put it down on the bed in front of him, and he looks at it. He said, what is this? I said, it's your bacon and eggs. And he said, honey, I'm rich. I used to be really poor, and you know, we didn't have a lot of food to eat. And he said, this looks like when I was poor and didn't have enough food to eat. I said, I want you to go back down there and put at least six eggs together and a half a pound of bacon. I won't eat it all, but I just want to see it in front of me. I just want to know I can afford that. So, I mean, he's still felt he had such a humility, really, and still felt in his heart that he remembered when he was poor and didn't have enough food, and wanted to remind himself now he did.
That sense of where he came from seemed to always still be with him, and one of the things that we found out in talking to Angie still be with him, and one of the things that we found out in talking to Angie, the you know head of archives, is that you know Vernon saved everything because he was through the Depression, it could go away.
Yeah, absolutely.
That stayed with Elvis here.
Yeah, not as much with Elvis. Yeah. I mean, Elvis honestly didn't care about money. He didn't care about hoarding money. He had such a generous spirit. And he would often say, you know, I derive so much more pleasure from giving than receiving. He was a very difficult person to buy for, as you can imagine, because he had everything. And if he didn't have it, he could go out and buy it. Yep. And, you know, he spent his money. God bless him. He lived for the day. You know, he lived the way we all are admonished to live. You know, today is the present. This is the day we should grasp and rejoice in. You know, so he did live that way. But he derived incredible pleasure from giving, and would much rather see someone's face having received a gift from him than for them to bring him a gift. You know?
Yeah,
take it off, give it to you. You know, that's it. We called him Santa Claus because he had such a tremendous spirit of giving. He's an incredible person.
So how do you buy for the man who can buy anything for himself? How do you select a gift for him?
It was really difficult. You know, one of the best gift that I was ever able to give Elvis was the Maltese cross. You guys have all seen that beautiful Maltese cross that he wore all the time in his shows. So it was Christmas time, our second Christmas together, and not knowing that Elvis never did anything for himself, you know, he would never indulge himself as much as he would indulge other people, I went to Lowell Hayes and I said, listen, I have this design, this beautiful Maltese cross I would love to have made for Elvis, pave diamonds, my birthstone and his birthstone, turned sideways in a heart and joined by a single diamond with an eternity ring around those two hearts. Can you do this? And Lowell said, sure, I can. So I went back home to Graceland and I said, honey, I want to buy you a nice Christmas present this year. But of course, that means, of course, you'll pay for it. But I want to do it for you. And he said, okay, sweetheart, well, how much are we talking about? And I said, $25,000. He said, $25,000? And I said, now doesn't $8,000 sound better? So ladies, remember that, if you're, or gentlemen. So it made $8,000 a lot more palatable for him. And he said, he started laughing and he said, I see what you've done there. And he said, so honey, is it 25 or is it 8? And I said, it's $8,000. He said, sweetheart, if you want to spend $8,000 on me for Christmas, please go ahead. So I got him the Maltese cross and he absolutely adored it and wore it to every show thereafter.
Yeah.
Love and admire, and just little human touches like that. He always used Neutrogena soap, so he always had this little essence of that clean, fresh smell of Neutrogena soap. Their sales are going to go up, aren't they?
And
am I supposed to kiss and tell now?
Well, you can kiss and whisper. Well, remember what Jerry Reed said. Jerry Reed said, you know, Elvis, I'm not that way, but man, I'd kiss you. Kissing Elvis, you've come up with an explanation that perhaps
could
help.
The closest explanation that I could devise, and I wrote this in my memoir when I finally wrote a memoir. I said, if you take two big fluffy marshmallows, put them together, and the sweetness and the softness that they are, and you just kiss those marshmallows, that's the closest thing that I could come to imagining that would be like kissing Elvis.